Hello, thank you for having me here. I'm Georgy Potapov, I'm the project manager at the Research and Development Center SCANETS. I'm going to talk a little bit about our project we are currently working on, which aim to provide data based on spatial intelligence, real-time satellite monitoring data, spatial intelligence of natural fires in Russia and some neighbor countries, mostly countries of former Soviet Union also. And I'll talk a little bit later about how it's connected to OpenStreetMap. Here you see the point of real-time based services is the time, as you can guess, but it takes time, the whole process to be done. Here you see the basic scheme of very simplified of the process of acquisition of satellite imagery acquisition and then data processing and data delivery to the end user. Is on the first step we have ground receiving station, which is used for the satellite data acquisition. Next step we come to data processing. Data has to be processed. It can be processed automatically or some additional data can be put it in by experts. On the final step, we get to the issue how all this data can be delivered to the end user. So on the final step, we use our proprietary technology, which can be called as WebGIS platform for build services. User can interact with, can make some analysis, can get information, and for basic decision making support. So here are some examples of our services. This is services oriented for emergency, for I don't remember correctly, maybe for Russian state of emergency. And here you see a picture of taken from Big Bird or GRI satellite, I don't remember correctly. It's illustrated place of aircraft fall near Smolensk. On the next slide, here's Fukushima station, yeah, with destruction of buildings. Here we go to the project my topic is dedicated to, fires monitoring. So the main we've launched this project on next on the previous year on summer 2010. You, maybe you know it was abnormal high temperature and critical situation with fires in Russia. So we decided to make all data available on the internet for a wide range of users. Here you see all. Data collected for one day by network of ground receiving stations. So it mainly includes three items, maybe one in Moscow and another near Baikal Lake. So you see the patrols of satellites. Satellites flying all over the Earth and taking pictures. So here is a sample how this data is integrated to a service. Services based on mainly on modest satellite images. Data is copyright free and available publicly. So, but it has quite low resolution, about 250 meters per pixel. So you see hotspots of fires automatically detected by MOD 14 algorithm. It's a product based on raw modest data. So here we go to the next issue that was for us how can we aggregate some feedback from users in this service. Here we launched a project that was named the Project of the Week with our OpenStreetMap community. The burnt areas were mapped by RSM users and data was delivered to OpenStreetMap editor applications like Potlatch and Jossom to map it and to add some specific tags like burnt areas. Here you see more example, even more detailed, like spot imagery that is 20 meter resolution. The data was very useful for verification of automatic data based on models. So here you can see an example in, of outlining burnt area. And this data we get from we've got from this project was very useful for us in for our future plans. Here we've launched, for example, a new new based interface for the servers, which provide information combining it to clusters. Here in the center of circles you see a number of hot spots that are captured by one cluster, by clusterizers. So, and when we get closer, we see more detailed outlines of fires that are detected automatically. But we found a good correlation between data generated by users, created by users in SOTM project, and data obtained automatically by automatic algorithm. It's time to finish, and I'd like to finish with the message that information must be available publicly and must be available for third-party application. That's why we develop our API for this service and for third-party applications and services. Here are some examples of using it. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. It's Bernhard Fischer here.